Joining us now for our stock market segment, again, 12 minutes into trade, the PSE index is up by a tenth of 1%, 7 points. We're at 6958. Joining us is Mark Canizares of Manulife Investment Management and Trust Corporation. Mark, good morning. Good to see you.
Good morning.
All right. So, Mark, we're not seeing a so-called inflation sell-off, are we? I mean, despite overshooting estimates, hotter than expected inflation print for February, we're actually trending up. Why do you think so?
Well, first, it's good to be back. But it's still quite early in the trading day. It's still just a few minutes since the market opened. Yes, I think 3.4% was not really what the market was expecting. But if you dig deeper into the numbers, there are some positive signs. Like, for example, yes, food was up. But if you look at the month-on-month changes, it's only 0.3% in February versus I think we saw 0.8% month-on-month in January. So you're seeing some tempering of that print, even if it's still beyond what the market was expecting. Remember, the numbers are now within what the BSP is targeting at 2-4%. So that might be a bit of a consolation for the market, which is why the market is still quite flattish at this point. Another point is that if you remember last year, we ended quite on a flat note. And we think that there's still a big runway for the market to catch up with its Asian peers. So I think so far this year, with the exception of Japan and Vietnam, we're actually the best performing market in the region. But we still have a lot to catch up in terms of the gains. So we think if there are specific catalysts that are specific to the Philippines, then that might provide room for the market to finally re-rate in line with its Asian peers.
Room to finally re-rate. And re-rate to what? How big is this runway? Well, how high can we go?
Well, if you look at value.
All right, I think we lost the audio. Mark, we lost your audio.
Yep, can you hear me?
Okay, perfectly. Go ahead.
Yeah, so we were talking about valuations, right, in terms of a runway for a re-rating. We've ended 2023 with valuations closer to 10 times forward PE. Now our historical averages are at around 15 times. So you can see there's a potential for a re-rating of about 30, 40, 50%. So that's where maybe your blue skies are. But what the market needs, of course, is something that's specific that might push investors to invest back into the Philippines that can unlock the market's potential. And we've seen that. We've seen the fourth quarter GDP numbers, the full year 2023 numbers, quite encouraging. And I think this government currently has this impetus to actually increase infrastructure spending. I believe the government is looking at a 5-6% infrastructure spend as a percentage of GDP over the next couple of years. And, well, the president is currently, I think, in Australia, right, trying to also get investments. And the infra projects alone that's already lined up for bidding or in various stages are close to already 43 to 45 billion. And that would be basically on all areas, airports, roads, trains, all of these things. And that infra push might be our differentiating point versus, of course, the more popular thematics that's working globally, such as AI, tech spending.
All right. So we can count on the build better more. So, you know, when you take a step back, catch your breath, what is the strategy to win in a market like this with, as you say, a significant upside, but still a lot of uncertainties floating around? What do you tell your clients? What do you advise investors to do today?
Well, behaviorally, we should be patient. Markets have been quite volatile, and patience is actually something that is needed in markets like this. For example, infrastructure spending, it's not something that will filter through to earnings in 3 months. You won't see loans actually go up 50% just because a conglomerate or a consortium won an infrastructure project to rebuild the airport. It's not something like that. This is a longer term horizon.
All right. I think we lost the audio again, Mark. There. Hi.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. All right, so be patient in this market. Just very quickly, I have one. It's pretty quiet on the disclosures front. If I could just share with you one of the few stories that we have. ASEAN Australia is partnering with Madhubani Asian Power Singapore to develop a 200 megawatt battery energy storage system in Australia. Just very quickly, do you like the RE narrative or do you think prices are overstretched already?
But I think there's still that ongoing shift, right? Mm. But in terms of that sector, it's relatively new. So again, going back to that argument that we need to be longer or be patient more in this market. Battery storage is the next phase of renewable energy, right? Mm. Storing solar energy. So I think there's still more potential for this space in terms of expansion or in terms of development. So certainly we're looking at that space currently. And for the Philippines, of course, our energy mix is still predominantly coal, as I mentioned before. So there's that potential for a lot more players actually to involve themselves in renewable energy. And we're seeing that trend already happen, not just with ASEN, but also with the other players that are already even in the listed market in the Philippines.
All right. On that note, Mark, always a pleasure speaking with you. Just very quickly, you did say that the 3.4% inflation, it's still too early in the day. But I wonder, do you think it significantly clouds or changes the rate path outlook for the BSP? Or, you know, they say one number doesn't make a trend.
Well, I think there is still that expectations that there will be a rate cut sometime this year. The 3.4%, as I've said, it's already within the target of the central bank. So yes, there are upside risks to the inflation number. And I think that's what the BSP and the market is watchful. But certainly if the trend of, let's say, below 4% is sustained for the remainder of the year, even the month-on-month growth in terms of the inflation print slows down below the 0.3% that we've seen, then there's really scope for the central bank policy to be more accommodative at this point, which would actually translate to more positivity in terms of the market sentiment.
All right. On that note, pleasure to speak with you, Mark. Thank you so much for the insights and the time. We'll see you soon.
Thank you. Thank you.